Hi everyone. This is motherboard of Asus S551LN laptop. Water spilled on it. But I should say that is cleaned before. It was heated before. This IC has been heated before. Some other blocks were heated as well. When I first checked the motherboard, the only present voltage on circuit was it was on this coil which is related to battery charge. 1.5 volt was present on it, and voltage was absent in the rest of the blocks. 19 volt was absent even on input of these MOSFETs. So I started checking, and I started with adapter jack. 19 volt was present in here. I'll also explain it on the board view later. I found AC adapter input MOSFETs on Boardview. 19 volt was present on drain pin of this MOSFET, but it was absent on its source pin. So I clicked on its gate pin, and I found the driver IC on the Boardview, which was the charge microcontroller, PU800, right? I think yes. I'm saying this so that repairmen who watch this video would have a clear view and know which component we'll talk about later. PU2800. This is PU2800 that drives AC input MOSFETs. And as it was heated before, I removed it from the circuit and placed it back again carefully. And then the problem was solved. Most of the voltages got present, but laptop didn't turn on completely. Three of the LEDs turned on and off frequently. Then when I followed the process and checked the voltages, CPU underscore core voltage was absent, and VGA underscore core voltage was absent as well. These six MOSFETs provide voltage for graphic chip. And there are two MOSFETs in here and with this coil. They provide voltage for CPU. But 1.05 volt of CPU was present. 3 and 5 ALW voltages were present as well. And 1.35 volt of RAM was present in this status too. Then I checked the other side of motherboard. Let me show it to you. This is microcontroller IC of CPU underscore core. And this IC drives VGA underscore core. As you may know, before VGA underscore core voltage is provided, we should check CPU underscore core, which means if they are provided one after another, CPU underscore core must be provided first and it should be okay. Its power underscore okay voltage should be transferred to IO, and CPU needs to start working, so that it would let VGA underscore core voltage to be applied. So I focused on checking CPU underscore core microcontroller and realized that there is corrosion on the circuit in here. Then I removed the corrosion. As you see, resistor was placed vertically. There was corrosion on circuit. Then I placed resistor horizontally, and the problem was solved completely. Let me show the troubleshooting process on the board view. This is the board view. I start from adapter jack. J6001 is the adapter jack. As you see, pin 1 is plus 19 volt. Let me click on it. So as there is no schematic, we can track the direction in this way. There are three coils in here. PL6000, PL6001, PL6002. They transfer voltage as parallel. I click on pin 2 of one of these coils. As you see, all three coils turned on. Let's check where it goes. The capacitor is obvious. As you see, one of its pins is GND. This is the filter capacitor. In other parts of the board, the part on the bottom is yellow, which is a diode. It can't the intended one. Let's go back. Yes, in here. These are the two MOSFETs that I showed you on the board. This is the drain pin. Now let me click on its source pin. Source pins of PQ8801 and PQ8802 turned on together. This transfers 19 volt. And it will be transferred from its source pin to drain of this MOSFET. Then it goes to all the related blocks. When I checked these MOSFETs, I realized that voltage was absent on their gate pins. I click on pin 4 to see which component drives them. Because when I checked around them, I didn't see any microcontrollers. Excuse me, could you please show it on the board? The part that you said there is no microcontroller around these two MOSFETs. Where are the two MOSFETs now? These are the two MOSFETs. By looking at this block, you see that there is no microcontroller. Let me show the back as well. There is an IC in here which is related to LAN circuit. So this can't be it. We can find it by checking ohm as well. But checking board view is easier. And more sure. Now I show you the small components around MOSFET which are turned on. This is capacitor, it can't be it. We should check the resistors. PR8809 resistor. I click on its pin 2 to see where it is. PU8800 microcontroller turned on at the bottom. Its pin 4 is turned on. Have a look at the list on right. ACDRV is written in here. So AC MOSFETs are driven from pin 4 of PU8800 microcontroller. And as I said, I removed the IC and placed it back again carefully. And then the problem was solved. 19 volt was applied to the circuit. Then in the following, which means in the second part of troubleshooting, CPU_core was absent. Sorry, what happened when you placed microcontroller back again? It turned on, some voltages were present. But CPU_core and VGA_core were absent on the circuit. It didn't turn on completely and the LEDs blinked. For example, they were on for 3 seconds and they were off for a second. Exactly like, restart, status. Then when I checked, the VGA_core and CPU_core voltages were absent. Let me show it in here. As you see, PL8501. NVVDD. NV is usually related to graphic chip. This coil is like that as well. They cooperate. You can realize it by clicking on it. Two coils work together. And 6 MOSFETs which are around them. PQ8508, 09, 01, 03, 04. Another one is on the back. Two of these are low. Meaning, one pin is connected to GND. And the other MOSFET is high. To which, 19 volt enters its drain pin. And as I said, before VGA_core. CPU_core should be present, which is this coil. Take a look, plus VCC is written in here. Usually the coils near CPU are related to CPU. I know it with my experience and it is written in here as well. Plus VCC voltage is usually related to CPU. Could you show these coils on the board as well? Yes, I showed it before too. This is PL8001, which has a MOSFET in here, and another MOSFET on the back. They all together provide 1.7 volt of CPU_core. I should say that 1.05 volt is present in here, but 1.7 volt of CPU_core is absent. These two coils that I showed you, These and their 6 MOSFETs. 5 MOSFETs are in here and one is on the back. They provide voltage of graphic core. To show you how to find the microcontroller, I click on these. I click on coil pin. Is this graphic coil? No, it is CPU coil. As you know, pin 4 of MOSFET is gate pin. So I click on pin 4. So that we know which IC drives it? There is nothing in here. Let's see the other side. Pin 12 of PU8000. As you see, pin 12 is VCCIN_DL1. Which is in fact, low. Which means it drives the lower MOSFET. Take a look at here. Pin 9. Let me hold the mouse on it. Take a look, H means high MOSFET. MOSFETs are usually low and high and provide the output voltage. When I checked around this on mainboard, I found out there was corrosion. Let me show you the resistor that had corrosion. Let me show you this resistor on Boardview. This is the resistor, PR8020, which is placed vertically. This pin was completely oxidized on PCB circuit, and it was corrosion on it. And the other pin is connected to pin 7 of IC. Meaning, 19 volt enters this IC through the resistor. It is VRMP circuit. I removed this pin's corrosion. As this block of PCB circuit was completely corroded, I placed this resistor horizontally. That I'll show you on the mainboard again. This is the resistor. PR8020. And the mainboard problem was solved by cleaning the corrosion of PBC circuit. And laptop turned on. Is there anything else? No thanks. Let me talk about the purpose of this video. Even though this laptop was troubleshot before, we couldn't capture a proper video back then. Actually we did, but there was no sound on the video. But it would be such a waste not to share such problems troubleshooting with Boardview. So we decided to explain the troubleshooting process with Boardview. This mainboard was not very familiar for me, and I hadn't worked with such mainboards. And as I thought other repairmen might face such unfamiliar mainboards that they hadn't worked with before, and there wouldn't be any schematics. But if the board view is available, you can troubleshoot the mainboard by clicking on each block and finding the directions. The purpose was to explain troubleshooting process with board view. I hope it's useful, smiley face.